What's up, guys? Welcome back to the King of Random Labs, where I've got a little experiment cooking up for you today. Now, the inspiration for this experiment today goes back to the video where we made the pull-tab smoke grenades. You might remember I cooked up a huge batch of this rocket fuel to the point where it was spilling over the edges and almost making contact with the burner itself. That made me a little bit nervous because there was a chance the whole thing could go up in my face at once. So the purpose of this experiment is to find out just that. How much heat can this mixture take before it will spontaneously burst into flames? Oh, and we're gonna test gunpowder too. Now, if you ever stop to read the labels of any pyrotechnic composition, including fireworks, you'll probably see it asks you to store it in a cool, dry place away from any flames, heat, or sparks. But the question really is, how hot is too hot? I mean, say you have this stuff sitting in your garage in the middle of summer, and it gets incredibly hot in there. At what temperature can we reasonably expect this stuff will go off? Not really sure, so let's find out. And the other question on my mind is, what exactly happens to gunpowder when you put it on the stove? Does it melt together? Does it go off in flames? Or does it sit there and do nothing? Let's get cooking and find out. So here's what we're working with today. I've got a 20 gram mix of our rocket fuel because when this goes off, it's gonna generate a lot of smoke and I wanna limit it to 20 gram batch. We've also got some Pyrotechnics muzzle loading propellant, as well as some Green Dot smokeless gunpowder for reloading cartridges. Let's start off with the rocket fuel first. We'll throw this white powder in a pan, heat it up until it caramelizes it, and keep cooking it until it burns to a crisp. I've also got an infrared thermometer so we can keep track of the temperature, as well as an IR camera so we can actually see the heat changes taking place. Now this is gonna take just a minute for this to start to warm up. If I use a spatula, we can help disperse the heat a little more evenly. What's interesting is this starts off as a white powder, but the sugar begins to caramelize and turns into a syrup and absorbs the potassium nitrate into it. And once it hits that consistency, we just back away slowly and let it cook. Electricity's buzzing. Bring out our temperature gauge here. We're starting off at about 76 degrees Fahrenheit. That's about room temperature right now. If we go over to the burner, showing about 74 as well. So the heat is just coming onto that. All right, so it's been about 45 seconds. We're up to 85 degrees Fahrenheit. The burner is now at 132, so we're definitely on the rise. Looking good. Infrared camera's rolling. At this point, we just buckle down and watch. This is usually about the point where I start getting nervous, because when I see this stuff burning, it makes me feel like it is gonna burst into flames. All right, we're up to 350 now. There's quite a bit of smoke coming off of this right now. A lot of little black spots where you can see everything's been charred. And it almost looks like this composition is cooking and drying out. The bubbling is starting to reduce. Now the burner itself is over 500 degrees, so it shows there is still quite a bit of heat that can go into that pot. So I think we still have a chance of getting this to go off here. Oh, we're up to 400 now. So the temperature is starting to rise. You can see all the bubbling stopped. It's not gooey and bubbly like it was before. It's pretty much flattened out for the most part. Looks like a burnt oatmeal cookie. Now, I've never played with rocket fuel that was hot before. There's a chance that this could combust very vigorously. If it starts from the bottom, it could actually explode out of the pot and spew rocket fuel all over my workshop. Might be a good time to put on a lab jacket. Checking with the temperature gauge, it seems to have leveled off around 420 degrees Fahrenheit. It's not climbing much more than that. But this whole thing is nearly black at this point. Black and very burnt brown. There's no bubbling, there's no movement, there's no hissing, it's just sitting there, stagnating, and I'm starting to wonder if it's even gonna go off at all. Of course, if it doesn't, that would be the best thing that could happen to us because we don't want this stuff going off while we're cooking it, do we? So you know what I'm gonna do is grab a fork and let's poke this thing and flip it over like a pancake and cook both sides. Oh wow, it's very light and crispy, almost like a meringue. So interesting update, guys. It's been about 15 minutes we've been cooking this thing on high heat. We've got it up to 430 degrees Fahrenheit. And instead of combusting into a giant ball of flames, instead it's burnt itself into a black ash. And at this point, I'm not even sure if it's still flammable. So why don't we take a spoonful of it and apply it directly to the burner itself? All right, here we go. Oh, it did go off a little bit. Interesting. Okay, so wow, and come look at the residue here. It's got kind of some sticky, gummy, syrupy residue. Oh, look up in the ceiling. You can actually see all the smoke clouds lingering in the ceiling here. Now, we got this mixture up to 400 degrees Fahrenheit and it would not go off, but when we applied it directly to the burner, it did go off relatively quickly. The difference is the burner is 740 degrees Fahrenheit while the pot itself was just 400. So the auto ignition temperature must be somewhere in between that. I guess the lesson to learn from this is if you're cooking this stuff, make sure it doesn't fall on the burn. All right, so just for fun, let's go ahead and pour the rest. Sweet, look at the smoke roll on the ceiling. Interesting update, guys. The syrupy stuff stuck to the burner isn't a sugar composition at all. It's actually molten potassium nitrate. And we can tell that because if we use something like a paper towel to wipe it up, it instantly begins to combust. All right, guys, we got our workstation cleaned up and we did learn a few things, but I'm still not entirely satisfied. I wanna see the stuff burst into flames as the temperature's still rising. So this time I'm gonna make a new batch, a little bit smaller, and this time I'm gonna build it directly on the burner itself. It's amazing that hasn't gone off yet. 820 degrees Fahrenheit. I didn't even know the burner could get that hot. There it goes, oh wow. That was amazing. That was amazing. So we got up to 835 degrees Fahrenheit and then it spontaneously combusted and that went off really, really fast. It's like spitting all these little fireballs in every different direction. And that went off so fast, I really wasn't expecting it. By this point, I was almost giving up on it actually happening and then boom, there it goes. I have to admit that did take me a little bit off guard. Lots of fun, lots of fireballs, lots of smoke. That's really cool. That was amazing. So we got up to 835 degrees Fahrenheit and then it spontaneously combusted. And that went off really, really fast. And look at the black ash residue. If you look closely, you can still see the coals are glowing red down there. Look at that. If I blow on it, that is some of the glowing carbon left over from that sugar. Now that's up to temperature, let's put it on a little bit more and see if we have the same reaction. Interesting. So that was very encouraging, guys. We actually had to max out this burner and get up to 830 degrees Fahrenheit before the composition actually went off. So that makes me a lot more confident stirring this thing up because we really shouldn't be going over about 200, 250 at most. So there's a really nice wide range of buffer there when cooking up our rocket fuel. So now it makes me wonder, how would gunpowder react? Let's clean up this workbench and try that next. For our second experiment here, we're gonna try Pyrotechnics. I've got my burner back down to 420 degrees Fahrenheit right now. I'm not sure if that's too hot or not. So I'm just gonna take a small spoonful of this, sprinkle a few grains in the center, see what happens. It's already starting to smoke a little bit. 590 Fahrenheit. We're at 660 Fahrenheit and climbing. That's smoking pretty good though, isn't it? I feel like that's gotta go off in an instant. Any minute now. 670. So this is the Pyrotechnics mix. We've maxed out at about 900 degrees Fahrenheit, which is way higher than this thermometer can go, and apparently is as high as this can go. Now in looking at the powder, it's no longer a powder. It's mushed down and turned into some kind of a sludge, a black sludge. I don't know if it's still flammable or not. So to kill this stuff off, I'm gonna take a flame from a barbecue igniter and see if it will still ignite. Here we go, moment of truth. Yep, still works. Still works. So apparently our Pyrotechnics mix will not light off even at 800 to 850 degrees Fahrenheit. We had to go to the flame to get that to work. Next up, smokeless gunpowder. Same routine as before, and we're starting the burner at 580 degrees Fahrenheit and working our way up. So we're actually down to about 530 Fahrenheit here. Let's see how this works out. A little bit of powder in the middle, and there it goes. Wow, that was instant. And notice there is no smoke. That is smokeless. That's actually really cool. So, smokeless gunpowder apparently will take off a lot faster. Boom! And look, no smoke. No smoke, no residue. It's just churn and burn, and I could do this all day long. So just from this small experiment so far, I'd say that smokeless gunpowder is a lot bigger fire hazard than any of the other compositions we've played with so far. So I've let our burner cool down to 280 degrees Fahrenheit so we can add a small pile of smokeless gunpowder to the center of the burner and then bring up the temperature. I want to find out exactly what temperature this stuff goes off at. All right, let's turn up the heat. My guess is this is gonna go off somewhere around 390 and 400. And here's what we're looking at. We're currently 280 degrees Fahrenheit and starting to climb. 400, 420, 430. There it goes, 430 degrees Fahrenheit. 430 degrees Fahrenheit, that's pretty cool. Okay, so we're back down to 410 Fahrenheit and the verdict is, it'll still work, there's enough heat there. Enough residual heat. So I would say anywhere between about 390 Fahrenheit and about 430 is where this stuff is gonna go off. Interesting. Let's turn off the burner and talk about what we just learned here today. We entered this experiment with the purpose to find out what temperature our solid state rocket fuel would go off if it accidentally came in contact with the burner. From our experiments here today, we saw that it would not auto-ignite in the pot itself, but instead burn to a crisp and grind down into a fine black ash. But we also saw that when we transferred that ash onto the hot plate itself, it would still ignite. So we tried an experiment making a new batch of rocket fuel and running it right on the burner itself and found that it would auto-ignite somewhere around 830 degrees Fahrenheit. Next, we tried a commercial Pyrotechnic muzzle-loading propellant and put it directly onto the burner, where we maxed out the heat, maxed out the thermometer, and had no successful auto-ignition. Instead, it turned into some kind of a gloopy black paste, but we found that it still would ignite with a lick from a barbecue flame. Last but not least, we tried smokeless gunpowder. Putting that directly onto the hot plate, we found that it went up in an instant. So we cooled the burner down to around 280 degrees and slowly warmed it up from there, where it auto-ignited around 430 degrees Fahrenheit. We can come to the conclusion that the highest risk material for spontaneous combustion in your garage would be smokeless gunpowder. Although the chances of your garage getting up to 400 Fahrenheit aren't very high. Well, that is it for this set of experiments today, guys. Thanks for hanging out. I'll be looking for you in the next video. Talk to you then. Hey guys, thanks for watching, and remember, I'm giving away prizes now on every new video. All you have to do to qualify is subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and select to be notified when my next videos get released. The secret link to my giveaways will be pinned in the comments for the first 12 hours. If you like what I'm doing, show your support right now by giving this video a big thumbs up and share with a friend. I love you back, and I'll see you next time.